I've been very slack with my diary lately, so I thought I'd share this one with you because it's quite interesting. I've got a VFR 1200 for a full valve clearance service today, which is quite nice. With all the new parts laid out there, ready to go. It's having new pads, air filter plugs, all the usual stuff. I've also got a data tag kit as well for it. So I'll give you another update in a little while. Right then, bike's all stripped down. As you can see, the normal way I do things, everything laid out. Cam covers are off now, finally got it stripped down. Bit of a mission to get to the front cylinder. Couple of hours work really to get the air box and the throttle bodies and everything off it to get in there. Thought I'd share this bit with you. It's quite interesting actually. This is typical Japanese engineering, elegantly simple. To make the cylinder head much narrower, they've kind of gone back to the old school way of doing things. So rather than it being double overhead cam, there's one camshaft, and then there's a rocker arm for the exhaust valves. It's interesting doing the valve clearances actually. They give you a clearance for the inlet cam, which is 6 thou plus and minus one, but then they give you two measurements for the exhaust. They give you a roller measurement, so the clearance between the roller and the camshaft lobe, the exhaust camshaft lobe, which is 8 thou plus and minus one, or an exhaust valve clearance that you would normally do between the end of the valve stem and the adjuster, which is 12 thou plus and minus one. So it's quite interesting. They've gone back to an old school way of doing it. And the other thing, for you anoraks out there, they've also gone back to an old school cam chain tensioner, the wedge type that they used to use on old CBR 1000s and stuff like that. So there's no plunger type cam chain tensioner anymore. And these tensions used to be fairly unreliable, so they've obviously come up with a slightly better way of doing it. But anyway, that's the VFR 1200 valve clearance service so far. Bit of a snapshot. Valve clearances are all done now. The inlet valves, which are normal shim under bucket, they were all fine, but the lock nut and adjuster on the exhausts were actually out on all but one of the exhaust valves. So the throttle bodies are back on now, and it's going back together quite nicely. Home straight now. Airbox, rock bodies, everything's back together. Just got to put the lid on the airbox, put the fuel tank on, put new oil filter on, sump plug back in, put some oil in it and run it up.